WDP4B and WDG4 are powered by the 4,500 horsepower 16-cylinder 710 G3B engine from EMD. The WDP4B and the dual cab WDP4D have a higher top speed of 135 km per hour compared to the WDG4 and the dual cab WDG4D, which have a top speed of 100 km per hour. The difference in speed performance of these locomotives is an outcome of how tractive power is transferred to the wheels. Horsepower is the power available for the locomotive to perform its functions. Tractive effort is the force required to do the job. Horsepower and tractive effort are not interconvertible, but are related by speed in the following manner. Force into distance equals energy, and energy upon time equals power. Therefore, power equals force into distance upon time. Since distance upon time equals speed, it follows that power equals force, that is attractive effort, into speed. Attractive effort equals power divided by speed. Tractive effort is inversely proportional to speed. This means at high speeds, the tractive effort will be low. And if higher tractive effort is needed, the speeds have to be kept low. Locomotives are powered by electric motors, and locomotive speed is regulated by manipulating the electricity supply to the motors. A throttle lever is used to vary the voltage inputs to the traction motor and therefore the speed. The throttle lever has 8 driving positions numbered 1 to 8. Each position is known as a notch, and the lever is advanced through the notches in a stepped fashion. Putting the throttle into notch 1 engages a set of contactors, which are massive electrical relays. These contactors link the main generator to the traction motors. Each notch engages a different combination of contactors, producing different voltages. Some combinations of contactors put certain parts of the generator winding into a series configuration that results in a higher voltage. Others put certain parts in parallel, resulting in a lower output. The diesel engine also needs to rev up with each notch, and this is achieved by means of further relays that adjust the fuel injectors. Gears manipulate how much of motor RPM is actually transferred to the axles. Gear ratios therefore determine the final track speed of a locomotive. The WDG4 has a gear ratio of 90:17. This means the motor gear has 17 teeth and the axle gear has 90 teeth. Therefore, for 5.29 revolutions of the motor gear, the axle gear makes 1 revolution. The WDP4B and WDP4D have a gear ratio of 77:17. In these locos, 4.52 revolutions of the motor gear result in 1 revolution of the axle gear. Clearly, in the passenger versions, the axle is rotating at a higher RPM than the freight versions. This is the reason a 4,500 horsepower passenger version WDP4 has a faster running speed than a 4,500 horsepower freight version WDG4. But the WDG4 has a tractive effort of 55 tons compared to the 41-ton tractive effort of a WDP4. In consequence, even though the WDG4 is slower, it can pull heavier loads compared to a WDP4. It must be mentioned that the WDP4B and WDP4D are not higher horsepower variants of the 4,000 horsepower WDP4, but are actually re-geared versions of the WDG4.